What is meant by a linear equation? In terms of x and y, a first order degree equation is called as a linear equation. That is, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. In terms of x and y, a first order degree equation is called a linear equation. Suppose a linear equation with one variable is called what? Suppose, for example, in the linear equation, how many variables are there? Two variables are there. Okay, now let us suppose it is only one variable. That is, either ax plus c is equal to 0 or by plus c is equal to 0, which is called as a simple equation. That is, a linear equation with one variable is called as a simple equation. And a simple equation has only one solution, that is a unique solution, that is ax plus c is equal to 0, x is equal to minus c by a, or by plus c is equal to 0, y is equal to minus c by b. Then what about a linear equation? A linear equation has infinitely many solutions. Okay, what we learn from this is, a simple equation has a unique solution and a linear equation has infinitely many solutions. A1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0. A2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0 are two linear equations. Then immediately, three different cases we can arise here. What are the three different cases? Now, these three different cases are distinct. That is, one is different from the other. That means possibility cases. Case 1. If a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, then these are called consistent lines, are consistent to each other. What is meaning of consistent? It is the nature is a consistent. Then see, so let us suppose, for example, this is the line L1. Next, the line L2. That is, consistent means they have at least one solution. That is a unique solution. Unique solution is different from the at least one solution. That the two lines are intersect each other, then the lines are called consistent. Another case is A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. Case 2. If A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2, then what is the nature of the graphs? Let's see. X, Y. This is the line L1. This is the line L2. That is, the condition, if A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2, then the nature of the lines are parallel lines. For parallel lines, there is no solution, which is called as inconsistent . Next case 3, if A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2, then the lines are coincident. If A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2, then the nature of the lines are coincident to each other. That is, the nature of the graphs. See, x y that is L1, L2. What's the mean for that? For the same line, here you name it as a L1, here name it as a L2. What's the mean for that? That is L1 and L2, both the lines are coincide to each other. Okay, let us, for example, now let us see these, we can see the two hands. Okay, now you can see these two are the two different models. Okay, then let us see them. If you join to each other, that means one is overlap with each other, then we can see from the front side it is only one. But see, now in the similarly, now we can learn three different cases. If a1 x plus b1 y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2 x plus b2 y plus c2 is equal to 0, or the pair of linear equations, then three different cases we can arise. The case 1, a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. That is, the nature of the lines are the consistent and the lines intersect each other. Condition 2, if a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2, these the nature of the lines are inconsistent and the lines are parallel to each other. And condition 3, if a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2, then they are coincide to each other. For this one also you have the infinitely many solution. Therefore, it is also called as consistent lines. Identify the following, which are intersect, parallel and coincident. That means from our previous knowledge, the pair of linear equations has three different in nature. That is either intersect or parallel or coincident to each other. Okay, let us see some example. Now, example 1. That is 2x plus 3y minus 4 is equal to 0, comma 5x minus 2y plus 7 is equal to 0. Now, identify the positions of a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. First of all, write the positions of these three. After that, we can able to understand this one very easily. Now, a1 by a2, that is a 2 by 5. b1 by b2, that is 3 by minus 2. C1 by C2, that is minus 4 by 7. That means, first of all, these two are not a tallied. That is, I can conclude that A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. Therefore, given lines are intersect each other. Given lines are each other. Now, come to example 2. 2x minus 3y plus 4 is equal to 0. Next, second equation, 4x minus 6y plus 7 is equal to 0. Similarly, identify the positions. Come on, a1 by a2 is equal to 2 by 4, b1 by b2. Is equal to minus 3 by minus 6, c1 by c2 is equal to 4 by 7. Now, that is a1 by a2, which can be simplified. a1 by a2 is equal to 1 by 2, because convert this one into the standard fraction. After that, b1 by b2, which can be also converted into the simple fraction 1 by 2. And c1 by c2 already is in the standard fraction. Therefore, no need to simplify it again. After this one, now if you identify a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 and this is not equal to c1 by c2. That means, according to your case 2, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is not equal to c1, means given lines are parallel to each other. Parallel means the lines never touch each other. That means if the lines are parallel, it has no solution. Okay, this is the point you have to remember. Now, example 3. 3x minus y minus 3 is equal to 0. Next one. 9x minus 3y minus 9 is equal to 0. Observe these two equations. Now consider the equations 3x minus y minus 3 is equal to 0 and 9x minus 3y minus 9 is equal to 0. Now identify the positions. A1 by A2 is equal to 3 by 9. B1 by B2 is equal to minus 1 by minus 3. C1 by C2 is equal to minus 3 by minus 9. Now, please arrange this into the standard fraction, that is 1 by 3, b1 by b2 which is equal to minus minus get cancelled, that is a 1 by 3, c1 by c2 is equal to minus minus get cancelled, that is equal to 1 by 3. Okay, from the above positions, I conclude that a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2 is equal to same answer, that is a 1 by 3. Therefore, according to our previous knowledge, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. The given lines are called coincident lines and it has infinitely many solutions. The pair of linear equations we can solve in three different methods. That is methods of solving pair of linear equations. Method 1. Elimination method. Number 2, substitution method. Number 3, cross multiplication method. That means we can solve the pair of linear equations in three different methods. Number 1, elimination method. Number 2, substitution method. Number 3, cross multiplication method. What is meant by elimination method? That means, you know, in linear equations we have two variables, that is x and y. Let us suppose in the elimination method, first case, suppose for example 2x minus 3y is equal to 4, x minus 3y is equal to 5. That is, here coefficient of y and coefficient of y in both the equations are same. Then if I just change the signs, I can eliminate these two. If I eliminate, the given question is reduced into two variables to the single variable. Then it is very easy to find the other variable for us. Okay, now let us see 2x minus x, that is x, 4 minus 5, that is a minus 1. Now I got the x value. By substituting the x value in the above equation, you can get the y value. This is the one of the method to solve pair of linear equations. Next, come to the second method, substitution method. Substitution method means, suppose for example 2x minus y is equal to 4 is there. It is the one of the linear equation. First of all, you have to check out of these two, which variable is a simple with the coefficient. That is, x has a variable 2, y, x has a coefficient 2 and y has a coefficient 1. From these two, y coefficient is a simpler than x. Therefore, convert this one, 2x minus 4 is equal to y. Substitute this value in the above equation. Now, come to the third one, that is called cross multiplication method. Now, what is the formula to develop from the given polynomial, from the given linear equations? Now we can see. Now let us suppose, see, if a1x plus b1y, a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, comma a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0 are the two pair of linear equations. How to develop a formula to find the cross multiplication method? Now see, arrange the coefficients like this, b1, c1, a1, and at last again b1. Similarly, from the second, start from the b2, c2, next a2, and at last repeat b2. Now this part is considered as x, this part considered as y. Now to get the x value, do cross multiplication. B1 C2 minus B2 C1 by the denominator parties go along like this. A1 B2 minus A2 B1. This is the formula to find the value of the x. Similarly, to find the value of the y. Follow, come on. C1 A2 minus C2 A1 by same in the both the cases, in case of x and in case of y, the denominator must be same. That is A1 B2 minus A2 B1. This is the formula we can use to find the value of the x, and this is the formula we can use to find the value of the y in cross multiplication method. Now see the next problem. For what values of the p, the following equations has a unique solution. First of all, please recall what is the condition for unique solution. That is, first question, 4x plus py plus 8 is equal to 0. 2x plus 2y plus 2 is equal to 0. Identify the positions a1 by a2 and b1 by b2. And unique solution means the condition is a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. That is, write a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. It is the condition to make the linear equations as a unique solution. Now apply the values a1 4 by a2 is 2 is not equal to b1 p by 2. Denominators are same, get cancelled. Even equal to, even not equal to, even not equal to also apply the same rules what you are doing with equal to. Now therefore p is not equal to 4. What is mean for this? P is not equal to 4 means p will take all the values, p will satisfy all the values but except 4. That is, that means if you substitute in place of p, you can substitute any number in place of p except 4, then the given pair of linear equations will satisfy the unique solution. Come to the second, that is b. That is, question is here. Now come on, the condition is a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. This is the condition to make the given linear equations as a unique solution. Now 3 by 6 is not equal to minus p by minus y. In the both the cases, y coefficients are under negative sign. That is why minus p by minus 1, minus minus get cancelled. That is, convert into simple fraction, 1 by 2 is not equal to p. That is, what is mean for this? In place of p, you don't substitute 1 by 2. That means p will take all the values except 1 by 2. Now come to the c again. A1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Substitute the values. P by 6 is not equal to minus 2 by 2. That is, P by 6 is not equal to minus 1. That is, you want to find the value of the P, that means P must be alone, that means you have to convert P as the subject. That is, if any number is related with the P in the form of the division, in the form of addition, in the form of multiplication, you have to convert P as the subject. You know very well, that is the coefficient of subject must be always 1. Therefore, P not equal to minus 6. What is mean for this in this question? Therefore, P will takes all the values except minus 6 to make the unique solution. Okay, the last one, again, A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. That is, substitute the values, that is 1 by P is not equal to minus 1 by 5. That is, make it the reciprocal, that is P is not equal to minus 1 by 5 means minus 5. Therefore, what is the mean for this is P will takes all the values except minus 5 to get the unique solution for the given linear equations. Our next problem. For what values of the k, the linear equations have infinitely many solutions? First of all, please recall what is the condition to make the given linear equations has infinitely many solutions. That is, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2 is the condition. Okay, let us follow this one. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. That is, K by 12 is equal to 3 by K is equal to, both the parts have the negative sign, that's why please eliminate, K minus 3 by K. Now you have to find out the value of the K, that is, let us see, equate these two, that is the part 1, I am equating these two. K into K, K square is equal to 12 threes are 36. That is, K is equal to root 36, K is equal to plus or minus 6. That means, in place of K, you can take either plus 6 or minus 6, you will get infinitely many solutions. Okay, now, or else, what is the other option? See, equate the first and the last. K by 12 is equal to K minus 3 by K. In this case also, see, K into K, K square is equal to 12 times K minus 3. That is, K square is equal to 12K minus 12 threes are 36. Now, arrange this in order. K square minus 12k minus 36. Now, find out the factors for 36. Whose subtraction will be 12? Now, 6 are 36. That is 6 plus 6. This is one of the alternate. Next, come to the second one. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. That is, 3 by 2k minus 1 is equal to 1 by k minus 1 is equal to, both the parts bring inside. That is, C1 by C2, 1 by 2k plus 1. You can equate, because all the three parts are equal. You can equate any two parts to get the value of k. That is, I want to equate the first two parts. That is, 3 times k minus 1 is equal to 2k minus 1. That is, 3k minus 3 is equal to 2k minus 1. Now, like terms, please write the like terms in one side, constants are other side. That is, 3k minus 2k is equal to minus 1 plus 3. That is, k is equal to 2. I got the value of k. Now, welcome to the third option. Third case, Again apply the same rule, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. That is, see, let us see, a1 by a2, that is 5 by 2 times k plus 1 is equal to 2 by k is equal to 2k by 3k plus 4. Now, in this case also, I want to equate the first two. That is, 5k is equal to 2 times 2, 4 times k plus 1 is equal to 5k is equal to 4k plus 4. That is, 5k minus 4k, bring the like terms to one side. That is, k value is equal to 4. Okay, next. Okay, now consider the second case in this one. We have to equate the first two. Now, I want to equate the next two. That is, 2 by k is equal to 2k by 3k plus 4. In the first case, we equated the first two. In the second case, we are equating the next two. Now, cross multiply. 2 times 3k plus 4 is equal to 2k square. Now, 6k plus, or else we will do in one more method also by shortcut. This is also very simple for us. Let us see. In both sides, you can cancel 2. Then, write the remaining part. 3k plus 4 is equal to k square. Now, arrange in order. K square minus 3k minus 4 is equal to 0. That is, which is converted into a quadratic equation. How to find the quadratic equation? We know very well. That is, 1 into 4 is equal to 4. That means you have to find out the factors of the 4. After subtraction, you must get the number 3. Factors are 4 ones are 4. 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. Yes, that is k square. Arrange this in order. X square minus 4k plus k minus 4 is equal to 0. That is, take k as common, k minus 4, plus in the second part, take 1 as the common, k minus 4 is equal to 0. Now, common factor is a k minus 4 and the other factor is a k plus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore, the values of k are k is equal to 4 or k is equal to minus 1. Please check with your first step. K value we got as a 4. From the second step, one more additional value, there is a minus 1 we got. Okay, you can consider either case 1 or case 2. Any one of the, as you like. Okay, from the given pair of equations, one of the coefficient is a missing one, that is a k. And you have to find out the value of the k by using the condition, the given pair of linear equation has a no solution. Now see, the pair of linear equations are x plus 2y is equal to 5, 3x plus ky plus 15 is equal to 0. If the pair of linear equations has a no solution, then the condition is a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. Now compare the coefficients, that is a1 by a2, which is nothing but 1 by 3. Equal to b1 by b2, nothing but the coefficients of the y, that is 2 by k. That is, after cross multiplication, k into 1 is equal to k, 3 2s are 6. That is, the value of the k is equal to 6. Come to the second question. Okay, let us see the second pair of linear equations. That is, the 4x plus ky plus 5 is equal to 0. 2x plus 3y plus 7 is equal to 0. According to
the given condition, the system of the pair of linear equations has no solution. That is, the condition is a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. That is, a1 by a2 is nothing but the 4 by 2 is equal to b1 by b2, nothing but k by 3. That is, 2 is equal to k by 3, therefore k is equal to 6. Therefore, the missing value k is equal to 6. Come to the case 3, 3x plus y is equal to 1, 2k minus 1 into x plus k minus 1 into y is equal to 2k plus 1. That is, the given condition a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. That is, 3 by 2k minus 1 is equal to 1 by k minus 1 cross multiply. 3 times k minus 1 is equal to 2k minus 1. Open the bracket. That is, 3k minus 3 is equal to 2k minus 1. Next, grouping. 3k minus 2k is equal to minus 1 plus 3. That is, 3k minus 2k, that is equal to k, is equal to minus 1 plus 3, that is equal to 2. Therefore, the value of k is equal to 2. What we learn from these three examples is finding the value of the k if the pair of linear equations has no solution. See your next model. What is the objective? To convert word problems into a pair of linear equations. That is, from now onwards, the problems will be expressed in terms of the words that you convert into pair of linear equations, and then you have to solve. Now, here the question is given. A fraction becomes 9 by 11 if 2 is added to both numerator and the denominator. And the case 2, if 3 is added to the both numerator and the denominator, it becomes means the fraction becomes 5 by 6. Then find the fraction. Now, let us follow the answer side. Let the numerator is equal to x and denominator is equal to y. Let my consideration numerator is equal to x and the denominator is equal to y. Okay, from data. From data, let us follow. What is the data is giving the information? A fraction becomes 9 by 11. When it becomes 9 by 11, if 2 is added to both numerator and the denominator. My numerator is a x. That is, x plus 2 by y plus 2 is equal to my fraction becomes 9 by 11. Now, let us cross multiply. 11 times x plus 2 is equal to 9 times y plus 2. That is, open the brackets, 11x plus 22 is equal to 9y plus 18. After that, what we have to do? We have to do the grouping. That means like terms, 11x, variable terms bring one side. 11x minus 9y is equal to 18 minus 22. That is, 11x minus 9y is equal to minus 4. This is equation 1. What is my learning objective? What is the objective is to convert word problems into a pair of linear equations. Okay, the given question is in terms of the words, I convert into a linear equation. Okay, come to the second part. If 3 is added to the both numerator and the denominator, okay, come on. X plus 3 by y plus 3 is equal to, then fraction becomes 5 by 6. Now, cross multiply, 6 times x plus 3 is equal to 5 times y plus 3. That is equal to 6x plus 18 is equal to 5y plus 15. Again, write the variables one side. That is, a 6x minus 5y is equal to 15 minus 18. That is, 6x minus 5y is equal to minus 3. This is equation 2. After that, you have to solve equation 1 and 2. Solve equation 1 and equation 2. That is, how to solve? We have three different methods. That is, by elimination method, by substitution method, by cross multiplication method. You can prefer any one of the methods which you feel the best. Okay, I want to convert this one by elimination method. Now, let us see. Coefficient of x is 11, coefficient of x is 6. Coefficient of y is 9 and coefficient of y is 5. Now, I want to equate the coefficients of y. That is, equation 1 into 5 and equation 2 into 9. Now, 5 into 11, 55x minus 5 9s are 45y equal to 5 4s are 20. That is minus 20. Come to the second one. 9 6 are 9 into 6, 54. 54x minus 9 5s are 45y is equal to minus 9 3s are 27. Now simplify. That is minus plus plus. Without changing the signs, coefficients of y are equal, but both are in the negative sign. That's why I change the symbol. That's the process is the subtraction. Now 55 minus 54 x is equal to minus 20 plus 27, that is 7. Now this is equation 3. What is x? Nothing but x, nothing but is a numerator. Now substitute equation 3 in equation 1. That is 11x, 11 times 7 minus 9y is equal to minus 4. That is 77 minus 9y is equal to minus 4. 77 plus 4 is equal to 9y. That is 81 is equal to 9y. There is a 9 table, 81 cancels 9 times. Therefore, y is equal to 9. Now, x value is a 7, y value is a 9. Therefore, fraction is equal to x by y. That is, what's x value is a 7, what's the y value is a 9. Therefore, the required fraction is 7 by 9. Next, second model on the fractions. Let us see this one, how to solve this one. If we add 1 to the numerator and subtract 1 from the denominator, the fraction reduces to 1. That means the fraction becomes 1. It becomes 1 by 2 if we only add 1 to the denominator. What is the fraction? Okay. Let numerator is equal to x, denominator is equal to y. Therefore, fraction is equal to x by y. Now from data, follow your data. If we add 1 to the numerator, that is 1 to the numerator means x plus 1, by subtract 1 from the denominator. Subtract 1 from the denominator means y minus 1 is equal to, the fraction reduces to 1. That is equal to 1. That is, cross multiply, x plus 1 is equal to y minus 1. Now x minus y is equal to minus 1 minus 1. that is x minus y is equal to minus 1, that is minus 2. That is x minus y is equal to minus 2. That is, this is equation 1. Now, come to the second case. From the second case, it becomes 1 by 2. It becomes 1 by 2 means the fraction becomes 1 by 2. If we only add 1 to the denominator, if we add only 1 to the denominator, means there is no changes in the numerator. That is, x by y plus 1 is equal to 1 by 2. That means cross multiply, 2x is equal to y plus 1. That is, 2x is equal to y plus 1. That is, 2x minus y is equal to 1. Okay. Now, this is equation 2. Previous question we solved by elimination method. Okay. Let us see this question by substitution method. Now see, here I want to convert x as a subject. That means x is equal to minus y, take other side, y minus 2. Highlight this apart. And let us consider this as equation 2 and convert this as equation 3. Now, substitute equation 2 in equation 3. Substitute equation 2 in equation 3. Okay, what's the equation 3? Let us write 2x minus y is equals to 1. Now, what is the x value? 2 times y minus 2 minus y is equal to 1. Let us open the brackets. 2y minus 4 minus y is equal to 1. That is, 2y minus y, y is equal to 1 plus 4, that is y is equal to 5. Now, y value is ready. Now, keep this as equation 4. Substitute equation 4 in equation 2. That is, what is the equation 2? X is equal to y minus 2. That is, x is equal to, what is y value? 5 minus 2. Okay, now x is equal to 3. Now I am ready with the value of x also. Therefore, fraction is equal to x by y. That is equal to, what is the x value? Replace the values of x and y. 3 by, what is the y value? 5. Okay, what we understand from these models? Very beginning itself, what is the objective? To convert word problems into the pair of linear equations, and then you have to be able to find out the values of x and y. Okay, therefore, my fraction is equal to x by y is equal to 3 by 5. Let us see the next model. Problems on the ages. 5 years hence, the age of the Jacob will be 3 times that of his son. 5 years ago, Jacob's age was 7 times that of his son. What are the present ages? Okay, in these problems, the important concept is the present age. From the present age to, we have to go ahead for future age. And we have to go back for the past age. Now, let us see, let present ages, age of Jacob is equal to x, then age of son is equal to y. Now, after that, 5 years hence means there is a future. That is, after 5 years. After 5 years, age of Jacob is equal to 5 years after means that is the present age of Jacob is a x. After 5 years means that is a plus 5. That is x plus 5. After 5 years, the age of Jacob must be x plus 5 years. Age of son is equal to y plus 5. Now, what is the condition here? Let's see. Let us see. 5 years hence, the age of Jacob will be means equal to. That is, 5 years hence, the age of Jacob will be 3 times that of his son. Okay, now in my hand, both the ages are there. Now, you can write from data. Age of Jacob is x plus 5 is equal to how much? 3 times. 3 times to his son. That is y plus 5. Now, x plus 5 is equal to 3y plus 15. X plus 5 is equal to, that is, bring the variables one side. There is a x minus 3y is equal to 15 minus 5. That is, x minus 3y is equal to 15 minus 5, that is equal to 10. This is equation 1. Now, case 2. That is, what is the case 2? 5 years ago is the second case, come on. That is, 5 years ago, now let us prepare the ages. Age of Jacob, present age of Jacob is x. 5 years ago means you have to move back, that is x minus 5. That is, similarly the age of son, that is y minus 5. Why we are doing here the plus? That is, after 5 years means there is a future tense. That is, 5 years ago means there is a past tense. That is, we have to subtract. Now, from data, what is the data is saying? Jacob's age was, what is the age of Jacob? X minus 5 equal to how much? 7 times that of his son. That is, 7 times y minus 5. That is, x minus 5 is equal to 7y minus 35. That is, x minus 7y is equal to minus 35 plus 5. That is, x minus 7y is equal to minus 30. This is equation 2. Now, solve equation 1 and 2. Equation 1 and 2. What is the equation 1? X minus 3y is equal to 10. What is the second equation? X minus 7y is equal to minus 30. Now see, the coefficient of x is the 1. The coefficient of x is also the 1. For elimination method, the must and should, the first condition, the coefficients of the variable must be same and they must be in opposite in sign. But both the x have the same sign. Then what? The process must be the subtraction. Minus, plus, plus. Both the terms are cancelled. That is, minus 3 plus 7, that is a 4y, is equal to 30. 10 plus 30, that is equal to 40. 4 table 40 cancels, that is a y is equal to 10. Y is equal to 10. Who is y? Age of son. Age of son is equal to 10 years. let us, this is equation 3. Substitute equation 3 in equation 1. That is x minus 3 times, what is the y value? 10 is equal to 10. That is x minus 30 is equal to 10. X is equal to 10 plus 30, that is x is equal to 40. Okay, x is equal to 40, that is x is equal to 40. Who is the x? Age of Jacob is equal to 40 years. Okay, let us see the next question. 2 years ago, father was 5 times as old as his son. 2 years later, his age will be 8 more than 3 times the age of son. Find the present age of father and son. Now let us suppose, very beginning, let present age of father is equal to x, son is equal to y. Yes. That means, let us, my supposition is that the present age of father is x years and the present age of the son is y years. Now, let us see, after that, 2 years ago, 2 years ago means, 2 years ago, which means it's a past tense, that we have to know to past, that is, age of father is equal to, present age of father is x, now, 2 years ago means, x minus 2, that is age of son is y minus 2. Now according to the question, see, 2 years ago father was 5 times as old, that is from data age of father is x minus 2 is equal to 5 times y minus 2. That is, x minus 2 is equal to 5y minus 5 2s are 10. That is, next step, grouping. X minus 5y is equal to minus 10. Minus 2, please take the other side, there is a plus 2. That is, x minus 5y is equal to minus 8. This is equation 1. Now, case 2. What is the case 2? 2 years later. 2 years later means that is the future tense. That is 2 years later. Then again write, what is the age of father? Age of father is equal to, what is the percentage of the father? Your supposition is x. Now 2 years later means, that is the future, that is x plus 2. Now again, the age of son is equal to y plus 2. Now, let us follow from the question, what information you will get. 2 years later, his age will be, his means father. Father age will be how? That is from data. His age will be, who is his father age will be, that is x plus 2 is equal to how? Is 8 more than 3 times the age of son. That is 3 times, what is the age of son? Y plus 2. And it is very clear, 8 more, that means 8 more means that is a plus 8. That is x plus 2 is equal to, open the brackets, 3y plus 3 2s are 6 plus 8. That is x plus 2 is equal to 3y, 6 plus 8, that is 14. Now grouping, x minus 3y is equal to 14 minus 2. That is x minus 3y is equal to 14 minus 2, that is 12. This is equation 2. Now what you have to do? That is solve equation 1 and equation 2. That is, the equation 1 is x minus 5y is equal to minus 8. Equation 2 will be x minus 3y is equal to 12. Come on, by elimination method, the more chances are to cancel is x, but the signs of both variables are same, then in such case it is not possible. Then what you have to follow? You have to change the signs, minus, plus, minus, then cancel. Now let us see, minus 5 plus 3, minus 5 plus 3 means that is minus 2y is equal to minus 20, minus minus get cancelled, y is equal to 10. Who is y? Son, that is age of son. Age of son is equal to 10 years. Let us suppose this is equation 3. Now substitute this equation 3 in equation 1. That is, you can substitute anywhere, either in equation 1 or in equation 2. That is also equation 1, that is x minus 5y is equal to minus 8. That is x minus 5 times y value is 10 is equal to minus 8. That is x minus 50 is equal to minus 8. That is x is equal to minus 8 plus 50. That is x is equal to 42. Also, who is x? The present age of the father. Therefore, age of father is equal to 42 years. Okay, from the question say, find the present ages of father and son. Therefore, present age of son is 10 years and the present age of father is 42 years. Okay, our next model is the same, to convert the word problems into the pair of linear equations. Now the problems on the digits. Problems on the digit means a two-digit number and the relation between unit digit to the tens digit and at the same time tens digit to the unit digit. With the help of that relation, you have to form the linear equation and you can able to solve the values of unit digit and the tens digit. Okay. And one more thing is the units digit, tens digit. Tens digit number is a maximum number is a 99. And tens digits, two-digit number starts with the 10 and ends with the 99. Now, let us see the information from the question. The sum of digits of a two-digit number is a 12. The number obtained by interchanging the digits. Interchanging the digits means units place moves to tens place and tens place moves to units place. Interchanging the digits. X is the number by 18. That means interchanging number is 18 more than the original number. Then find the number. Okay. Let us see. Let. My supposition is. Let's see. Units place, tens place. Now, units place is the x and the tens place is the y is the my supposition. And from data, sum of digits is given. Sum of digits is equal to 12 is given. That is given. Sum of digits is 12. Sum of the digits of a two-digit number is 12. That is, x plus y is equal to 12. This is equation 1. After that, let us see. How to find the number? Number means the formula 10 times the tens place plus 1 times the units place. This is the formula. That is, 10 times, what's the units, what's the tens place, y, plus 1 time units place, what's the units place, x. That is 10y plus x is your number. number is 10y plus x. After that, what I want? The number obtained by interchanging the digits. What I want next? Interchange number. Interchange in number means that is a 10x plus y. Now, from data, the number obtained by interchanging, what is the number obtained by interchanging? That is 10x plus y. Is how interchange the digits exceeds. How much exceeds 18 by the number? Number means it is the original number. Original number means 10y plus x. It will exceed by 18. Now, 10x plus y is equal to. Now, what we have to do is in this step, bring the like terms one side. That is 10x plus x bring to this side. That is a minus x. Is equal to 10y plus y take other side minus y plus 18, that is 9x, that is equal to 9y plus 18. Now what you have to do is 9x is equal to take 9 common from the both, that is y plus 2, 9 get cancelled, that is x is equal to y plus 2, which can be write as x minus y is equal to 2. This is equation 2. Now see, from my equation 1, x plus y is equal to 12. From my equation 2, x minus y is equal to 2. Now, what we have to do? Solve equation 1 and equation 2. That is, equation 1 is x plus y is equal to 12, which is a given information. After solving x minus, after simplification, x minus y is equal to 2. Plus y minus y get cancelled because of the opposite signs. That is 2x is equal to 14. Now x is equal to 7. X is equal to 7 means that is a unit place. Now this is equation 3. Substitute equation 3 in 1, that is x plus y is equal to 12, that is 7 plus y is equal to 12, therefore y is equal to 12 minus 7, that is a 5, y is equal to 5. Therefore, I am ready with the value of the x, value of the y. Therefore, original number is equal to, original number equation is 10y plus x, 10y plus x, that is equal to 10 times, what is the y value, see, what is the y value is a 7, plus units value, sorry, y value is a 5, and x value is 7. That is equal to 50 plus 7, that is equal to 57. That is 57 is your original number. Now let us check whether it is correct or not. Please go to your question. The sum of the digits of your 2-digit number is 12. Your 2-digit number is a 57. Now 5 plus 7 is 12. Okay, hence checking. Okay, let us see the next problem, which is based on the digits. A 2-digit number is 3 more than 4 times the sum of the digits. If 18 is added to the number, the digits are reversed. Find the number. Now here we have to focus on 3 steps. That is step number 1. You have to find out the number 1. You have to find out the number. Second is sum of the digits, and third one is a reverse number. Now let unit's place is x and the tens place is y. Let us suppose. Now, what is the sum of the digits? Sum of digits is equal to x plus y. After that, find the number. Number is equal to 10 times the tens place y plus 1 times the units place, that is x. Number is equal to 10y plus x. After that, what is the interchange in number? Interchange in number is equal to 10x plus y. That means if you interchange the digits, the number obtained is called interchange in number. 10x plus y. Okay. Now follow. From data, what information I will collect? A 2-digit number is, what is the 2-digit number? 10y plus x is nothing but equal to, is 3 more means 3 plus 4 times the sum of the digits. 4 times the sum of the digits means 4 times sum of the digits, you know, x plus y plus how much more? 3. That is, now simplify this step. 10y plus x is equal to, open the brackets, 4x plus 4y plus 3. Next, grouping, that is 10y plus 4y, bring this side, minus 4y is equal to 4x plus x, take other side, minus x plus 3. Now 10y minus 4y, that is 6y, is equal to 4x minus x, that is 3x plus 3. Now, in the RHS part, 6y is equal to, I want to take 3 as a common, that is x plus 1 left. 3 tables, 6 cancels 2 times, that is 2y is equal to x plus 1. Now, please make the grouping, that is minus x plus 2y is equal to 1. This is equation 1. Now let us consider the case 2 again. What is the case 2? If 18 is added to the number, first of all write the number. What is the number? That is, your number is 10y plus x. To the number 18 it will be added, that is 18 is equal to, what happened? Added to the number, the digits are reversed. The digits are reversed means we have to write the interchange in number, that is equal to 10x plus y. Now again grouping, x terms are one side and y terms are other side. That is 10y minus y is equal to 10x minus x minus 18. That is 10x plus x, bring to the other side, minus x plus 18 moves to the other side, that is minus 18. That is 9y is equal to 9x minus 18. Now 9y is equal to, from the RHS side take 9 common, that is x minus 2. 9 get cancelled. That is y is equal to x minus 2. Now therefore write this one in the equation form, that is variables other side, that is minus x plus y is equal to minus 2. This is equation 2. Now solve equation 1 and 2. What is the equation 1? Equation 1 is minus x plus 2y is equal to 1. What is the equation 2? Minus x plus y is equal to minus 2. then what you have to do? See, both the coefficients of both the equations are the same. In such case, I am unable to eliminate. Then change the signs, that is a plus, minus, plus. 2y minus y, that is a y. 1 plus 2, that is a 3. What is a y? What is a y? That is a tens place. Now, that is, this is equation 3. Therefore, tens place is equal to 3. Now, substitute equation 3 in your equation 1. What is your equation 1? Minus x plus 2y is equal to 1. That is minus x plus 2 times y value, I know that is a 3 is equal to 1. That is minus x plus 6 is equal to 1. That is minus x is equal to 1 minus 6 minus x is equal to minus 5. Both sides xx get cancelled. Therefore, see, x is equal to 5. What is the x name? Units place. Therefore, units place is equal to 5. Now I am ready with the units place and the tens place. Now you can prepare a number. Number is equal to, you know the formula, 10 times tens place. What is your tens place? 3 plus 1 time units place, that is a 5. That is equal to 10 threes are 30 plus 5, that is equal to 35. Therefore, your number is 35. Okay, let us follow the next example. Solve the system of equations. If you observe these two linear equations, we can observe one thing, that is, coefficients of x and y are interchanged. Coefficient of x is the 47 in the first one, and in the second one the coefficient of y is the 47. And the coefficient of y in the first one is the 31, and the coefficient of x in the second one is the 31. That is, coefficients are interchanged. Now, and at the same time in the second problem is also the coefficients are interchanged. In such cases, what is the procedure? Let us see. Now, first of all, write the follow the first one, that is, let us suppose this is equation 1, this is equation 2. What you have to do is, equation 1 plus equation 2 you have to do first. That is, equation 1 plus 2, that is, 47 plus 31, that is 7 plus 1, that is 8, 78x plus 78y is equal to 3 plus 5, 8, that is 78. Take 78 common, x plus y is equal to 78 get cancelled. That is, x plus y is equal to 1. This is equation 1. Similarly, what you have to do is equation 1 minus equation 2 you have to do next. Equation 1 minus equation 2, that is 47x plus 31y is equal to 63. 31x plus 47y is equal to 15. Now subtract 16x minus 16y. Now 13 minus 5, 8, that is equal to 8. 1 is borrowed, that is a 5 minus 1, that is a 4. That is, take 16 common, x minus y is equal to 48, 16 table 48, 3 table. That is x minus y is equal to 3. This is equation 2. Now solve equation 1 and equation 2. Equation 1 is x plus y is equal to 1, x minus y is equal to 3, 2x is equal to 4, x is equal to 2. Now I am ready with the value of x. Substitute equation 3 in equation 1. That is x plus y is equal to 1, 2 plus y is equal to 1, y is equal to 1 minus 2, y is equal to minus 1. Now, welcome to the second example. In the second example also, the coefficients of x and y are interchanged in equation 1 and 2. In equation 1, the coefficient of x is 19. And in the second equation, the coefficient of y is 19. Okay, now let us see now. To solve equation 1 plus equation 2. That is 19 plus 17. 36x. Now both are negative signs. Minus 36y is equal to, add 5 plus 3, 8, 5 plus 5, 10, that is 108. That is 36 take common, x minus y is equal to 108. That is 36 table 108, 3 times, that is x minus y is equal to 3. This is equation 3. Now, equation 1 minus equation 2, that is 19x minus 17y is equal to 55. 17x minus 19y is equal to 53. Here the process is subtraction. Please change the signs of lower equation. Minus, plus, minus. 19 minus 17, 2x plus 2y is equal to 2. Take 2 common, x plus y is equal to 2. 2 to get cancelled, that is x plus y is equal to 1. This is equation 4. Now solve equation 3 and 4. What is equation 3? X minus y is equal to 3. X plus y is equal to 1. Plus y minus y get cancelled because of the opposite sign. 2x is equal to 4. X is equal to 2. Now I am ready with the values of the x. Now, this is equation 5. Substitute 5 in any of the above equation. That is, I want to substitute in 4. That is, x plus y is equal to 1. That is, x value is a 2. 2 plus y is equal to 1. Y is equal to 1 minus 2. Y is equal to minus 1. Therefore, I am ready with the values of x and y. That is, x value is 2 and y value is minus 1. Okay, let us see your next example. Solve the system of equations by substitution. Now, first, the given equations, linear equations are in the irregular form. First, to convert that one into the regular form. After that, please follow the substitution method. Now, given equations are x by 2 plus y is equal to 0.8, comma 7 by x plus y by 2 is equal to 10. Now, first I convert this one into the regular form. That is, x plus 2y by 2 is equal to 0.8. That means the process I did here, the LCM. Now, x plus 2y is equal to 0.8 into 2. That is, x plus 2y is equal to 1.6. This is equation 1. Now, come to the second. First of all, please cross multiply. That is, 10 times x plus y by 2 is equal to 7. That is, the denominator part is a cross multiply towards to the 10. That is, after that, 10 times, complete the LCM. 2 times x, 2x plus y by 2 is equal to 7. That is, 2 table 10, 5 times. That is, 5 times 2x plus y is equal to 7. That is, 10x plus 5y is equal to 7. Now, from this one, it is followed by substitution method. Convert x as a subject. X is equal to 1.6 minus 2y. This is equation 1, this is equation 2. Substitute equation 1 in equation 2. That is, 10 times x value is 1.6 minus 2y plus 5y is equal to 7. That is, multiply with 10. 10 into 1.6, that is a 16, minus 20y plus 5y is equal to 7. That is, 16 minus 20 plus 5, that is minus 15y is equal to 7. Now, next, that is, minus 15y is equal to 7 plus 16, please move to other side, minus 16. That is, minus 15y, minus 15y is equal to 7 minus 16 minus 16 minus 7, that is a minus 9. That is, y is equal to 9 by 15. Convert this one into standard fraction. 3 table. 3 times, 3 table, 5 times. That is, y value is 3 by 5. Now, this is equation 3. Now, substitute equation 3 in equation 1. That is, x is equal to 1.6 minus 2 times 3 by 5. That is, x is equal to 1.6 minus 2 threes are 6 by 5. X is equal to 16 fives are, that is 80. That is 8 minus 6 by 5. That is, x is equal to 8 minus 6, that is 2 by 5. Therefore, the value of x is 2 by 5 and the value of y is 3 by 5. Okay, let us check whether these values are right or wrong in the given equation. Take any of the equation of your choice. Okay, I will substitute in this one. That is, x plus 2y is equal to 1.6. That is, x value is 2/5 plus 2 times y value is 3/5 is equal to 1.6. That is, 2/5 plus 2 threes are 6/5 is equal to 1.6. Denominators are same. Denominators are same means you can do the process what is there in the numerator. That is, the process is addition. 2 plus 6, that is 8. 8/5 is equal to 1.6. If you divide 8/5, you will get the answer 1.6 is equal to 1.6. That is, hence the answer. Okay, well, next model is the same. To convert the word problems into the pair of linear equations. Now, the problems on the digits. Problems on the digit means a two-digit number. And the relation between unit digit to the tens digit, and at the same time tens digit to the unit digit. With the help of that relation, you have to form the linear equation, and you can able to solve the values of unit digit and the tens digit. Okay. And one more thing is the units digit, tens digit. Tens digit number is the maximum number is a 99. And tens digit, two-digit number starts with the 10 and ends with the 99. Now, let us see the information from the question. The sum of digits of a two-digit number is a 12. The number obtained by interchanging the digits. Interchanging the digits means units place moves to tens place and tens place moves to units place. Interchanging the digits. X is the number by 18. That means interchanging number is 18 more than the original number. Then find the number. Okay, let us see. Let my supposition is, let's see. Units place, tens place. Now, units place is the x and the tens place is the y is the my supposition. And from data, sum of digits is given. Sum of digits is equal to 12 is given. That is given. Sum of digits is 12. Sum of the digits of a two digit number is 12. That is x plus y is equal to 12. This is equation 1. After that, let us see. How to find the number? Number means the formula 10 times the tens place plus 1 times the units place. This is the formula. That is 10 times. What's the units? What's the tens place? Y plus 1 time units place. What's the units place? X. That is 10y plus x is your number. Number is 10y plus x. After that, what I want? The number obtained by interchanging the digits. What I want next? Interchange number. Interchange number means that is a 10x plus y. Now, from data. From data, the number obtained by interchanging. What is the number obtained by interchanging? That is 10x plus y. Is how interchange the digits exceeds. How much exceeds? 18 by the number. Number means it is the original number. Original number means 10y plus x. It will exceed by 18. Now, 10x plus y is equal to, now what we have to do is in this step, bring the like terms one side, that is 10x plus x bring to this side, that is a minus x is equal to 10y plus y take other side, minus y plus 18, that is 9x, that is equal to 9y plus 18. Now what you have to do is 9x is equal to, take 9 common from the both, that is y plus 2. 9 get cancelled, that is x is equal to y plus 2, which can be write as x minus y is equal to 2. This is equation 2. Now see, from my equation 1, x plus y is equal to 12. From my equation 2, x minus y is equal to 2. Now what we have to do? Solve equation 1 and equation 2. That is, equation 1 is x plus y is equal to 12, which is a given information. After solving x minus, after simplification, x minus y is equal to 2. Plus y minus y get cancelled because of the opposite signs. That is 2x is equal to 14. Now x is equal to 7. X is equal to 7 means that is a unit place. Now this is equation 3. Substitute equation 3 in 1. That is x plus y is equal to 12. That is 7 plus y is equal to 12. Therefore y is equal to 12 minus 7. That is a 5. Y is equal to 5. Therefore, I am ready with the value of the x, value of the y. Therefore, original number, original number is equal to, original number equation is 10y plus x. 10y plus x, that is equal to 10 times. What is the y value? See, what is the y value? Is a 7 plus units value, y value is a 5 and x value is 7. That is equal to 50 plus 7, that is equal to 57. That is 57 is your original number. Now let us check whether it is correct or not. Please go to your question. The sum of the digits of your 2-digit number is 12. Your 2-digit number is a 57. Now 5 plus 7 is 12. Okay, hence the checking. Okay, let us see the next problem, which is based on the digits. A 2-digit number is 3 more than 4 times the sum of the digits. If 18 is added to the number, the digits are reversed. Find the number. Now here we have to focus on 3 steps. That is, step number 1, you have to find out the number 1, you have to find out the number. Second is the sum of the digits, and third one is the reverse number. Now let units place is a x and the tens place is a y. Let us suppose. Now, what is the sum of the digits? Sum of digits is equal to x plus y. After that, find the number. Number is equal to 10 times the tens place y, plus 1 times the units place, that is x. Number is equal to 10y plus x. After that, what is the interchange in number? Interchange in number is equal to 10x plus y. That means if you interchange the digits, the number obtained is called interchange in number. 10x plus y. Okay. Now follow. From data, what information I will collect? A 2-digit number is, what is the 2-digit number? 10y plus x. is nothing but equal to is 3 more. 3 more means 3 plus. 4 times the sum of the digits. 4 times the sum of the digits means 4 times sum of the digits, you know, x plus y plus how much more? 3. That is, now simplify this step. 10y plus x is equal to, open the brackets, 4x plus 4y plus 3. Next, grouping. That is 10y plus 4y, bring this side, minus 4y is equal to 4x plus x, take other side, minus x plus 3. Now 10y minus 4y, that is 6y, is equal to 4x minus x, that is 3x plus 3. Now in the RHS part, 6y is equal to, I want to take 3 as a common, that is x plus 1 left. 3 tables, 6 cancels 2 times, that is 2y is equal to x plus 1. Now please make the grouping, that is minus x plus 2y is equal to 1. This is equation 1. Now let us consider the case 2 again. What is the case 2? If 18 is added to the number, first of all write the number. What is the number? That is, your number is 10y plus x. To the number 18 it will be added, that is 18 is equal to, what happened? Added to the number, the digits are reversed. The digits are reversed means you have to write the interchange in number, that is equal to 10x plus y. Now again grouping, x terms are one side and y terms are other side, that is 10y minus y is equal to 10x minus x minus 18, that is 10x plus x, bring to the other side, minus x plus 18 moves to the other side, that is minus 18. That is 9y is equal to 9x minus 18. Now 9y is equal to, from the RHS I take 9 common, that is x minus 2, 9 get cancelled, that is y is equal to x minus 2. Now therefore write this one in the equation form, that is variables other side, that is minus x plus y is equal to minus 2. This is equation 2. Now solve equation 1 and 2. What is the equation 1? Equation 1 is minus x plus 2y is equal to 1. What is the equation 2? Minus x plus y is equal to minus 2. Then what you have to do? See, both the coefficients of both the equations are the same. In such case, I am unable to eliminate. Then change the signs, that is a plus, minus, plus. 2y minus y, that is a y. 1 plus 2, that is a 3. What is a y? What is a y? That is a tens place. Now, that is, this is equation 3. Therefore, tens place is equal to 3. Now substitute equation 3 in your equation 1. What is your equation 1? Minus x plus 2y is equal to 1. That is minus x plus 2 times y value I know, that is a 3 is equal to 1. That is minus x plus 6 is equal to 1. That is minus x is equal to 1 minus 6 minus x is equal to minus 5. Both sides x x get cancelled. Therefore, see x is equal to 5. What is the x name? Units place. Therefore, units place is equal to 5. Now I am ready with the units place and the tens place. Now you can prepare a number. Number is equal to, you know the formula, 10 times tens place. What is your tens place? 3 plus 1 time units place, that is a 5. That is equal to 10 threes are 30 plus 5, that is equal to 35. Therefore, your number is 35. Okay, let us follow the next example. Solve the system of equations. If you observe these two linear equations, we can observe one thing, that is, coefficients of x and y are interchanged. Coefficient of x is the 47 in the first one, and in the second one the coefficient of y is the 47. And the coefficient of y in the first one is the 31, and the coefficient of x in the second one is the 31. That is, coefficients are interchanged. Now, and at the same time in the second problem is also the coefficients are interchanged. In such cases, what is the procedure? Let us see now. Now, first of all, follow the first one, that is, let us suppose this is the equation 1, this is the equation 2. What you have to do is, equation 1 plus equation 2 you have to do first. That is, equation 1 plus 2, that is, 47 plus 31, that is 7 plus 1, that is 8, 78x plus 78y is equal to 3 plus 5, 8, that is 78. Take 78 common, x plus y is equal to 78 get cancelled. That is, x plus y is equal to 1, this is equation 1. Similarly, what you have to do is, equation 1 minus equation 2 you have to do next. Equation 1 minus equation 2, that is, 47x plus 31y is equal to 63. 31x plus 47y is equal to 15. Now subtract 16x minus 16y. Now 13 minus 5, 8, that is equal to 8. 1 is borrowed, that is a 5 minus 1, that is a 4. That is, take 16 common, x minus y is equal to 48, 16 table 48, 3 times, that is x minus y is equal to 3. This is equation 2. Now, solve equation 1 and equation 2. Equation 1 is, x plus y is equal to 1. X minus y is equal to 3, 2x is equal to 4, x is equal to 2. Now I am ready with the value of x. Substitute equation 3 in equation 1, that is, x plus y is equal to 1, 2 plus y is equal to 1, y is equal to 1 minus 2, y is equal to minus 1. Now, we'll come to the second example. In the second example also, the coefficients of x and y are interchanged in equation 1 and 2. In equation 1, the coefficient of x is the 19, and in the second equation, the coefficient of y is the 19. Okay, now let us see now to solve equation 1 plus equation 2. That is 19 plus 17, 36x. Now both are negative signs, minus 36y is equal to, add 5 plus 3, 8, 5 plus 5, 10, that is 108. That is 36 take common, x minus y is equal to 108. That is 36 table 108, 3 times. That is x minus y is equal to 3. This is equation 3. Now, equation 1 minus equation 2. That is 19x minus 17y is equal to 55. 17x minus 19y is equal to 53. Here the process is subtraction. Please change the signs of lower equation. Minus, plus, minus. 19 minus 17, 2x plus 2y is equal to 2. Take 2 common, x plus y is equal to 2. 2 to get cancelled, that is x plus y is equal to 1. This is equation 4. Now, solve equation 3 and 4. What is equation 3? X minus y is equal to 3. X plus y is equal to 1. Plus y minus y get cancelled because of the opposite sign. 2x is equal to 4, x is equal to 2. Now I am ready with the values of the x. Now this is equation 5. Substitute 5 in any of the above equation. That is, I want to substitute in 4. That is, x plus y is equal to 1. That is, x value is a 2, 2 plus y is equal to 1, y is equal to 1 minus 2, y is equal to minus 1. Therefore, I am ready with the values of x and y. That is, x value is 2 and y value is minus 1. Okay, let us see our next example. Solve the system of equations by substitution. Now, first, the given equations, linear equations are in the irregular form. First, convert that one into the regular form. After that, please follow the substitution method. Now, given equations are x by 2 plus y is equal to 0.8, comma, 7 by x plus y by 2 is equal to 10. Now, first I convert this one into the regular form. That is, x plus 2y by 2 is equal to 0.8. That means the process I did here, the LCM. Now, x plus 2y is equal to 0.8 into 2. That is, x plus 2y is equal to 1.6. This is equation 1. Now, come to the second. First of all, please cross multiply. That is, 10 times x plus y by 2 is equal to 7. That is, the denominator part is cross multiplied 2 words to the 10. That is, after that 10 times complete the LCM, 2 times x, 2x plus y by 2 is equal to 7. That is 2 table 10, 5 times. That is 5 times 2x plus y is equal to 7. That is 10x plus 5y is equal to 7. Now, from this one, it is followed by substitution method. Convert x as a subject. X is equal to 1.6 minus 2y. This is equation 1. This is equation 2. Substitute equation 1 in equation 2. That is, 10 times x value is 1.6 minus 2y plus 5y is equal to 7. That is, multiply with 10. 10 into 1.6, that is a 16, minus 20y plus 5y is equal to 7. That is, 16 minus 20 plus 5, that is minus 15y is equal to 7. Now, next, that is minus 15y is equal to 7 plus 16, please move to the other side, minus 16. That is minus 15y. Minus 15y is equal to 7 minus 16 minus 16 minus 7, that is a minus 9. That is a y is equal to 9 by 15. Convert this one into standard fraction. 3 table, 3 times, 3 table, 5 times. That is a y value is a 3 by 5. Now, this is equation 3. Now, substitute equation 3 in equation 1. That is, x is equal to 1.6 minus 2 times 3 by 5. That is, x is equal to 1.6 minus 2 3s are 6 by 5. X is equal to 16 5s are, that is 80. That is 8 minus 6 by 5. That is, x is equal to 8 minus 6, that is 2 by 5. Therefore, the value of x is 2 by 5 and the value of y is 3 by 5. Okay, let us check whether these values are right or wrong in the given equation. Take any of the equation of your choice. Okay, I will substitute in this one. That is, x plus 2y is equal to 1.6. That is, x value is 2 by 5 plus 2 times y value is 3 by 5 is equal to 1.6. That is, 2 by 5 plus 2 3s are 6 by 5 is equal to 1.6. Denominators are same. Denominators are same means you can do the process, what is there in the numerator, that is the process is addition. 2 plus 6, that is 8. 8 by 5 is equal to 1.6. If you divide 8 by 5, you will get the answer 1.6 is equal to 1.6. That is, hence the answer.
is equal to xkmph, let speed of stream is equal to ykmph. Next, here both boat and stream both are in the movement, then we have to consider the both the speeds, that is the stream speed as well as the boat speed, which is called as a relative speed. That is, a relative speed upstream is equal to x minus y kmph. Next, relative speed downstream is equal to x plus y. Why x minus y? Upstream means the stream direction and the boat direction are opposite to each other, then there will be the loss of energy. And stream direction as well as the boat direction, both are in the same direction, means there will be the gain in the energy, that is called as a plus kmph. Now, from data, after that we have to find out the time. Formula for time is distance by speed. Now, from data, see, a boat goes 30 kilometers upstream, that is 30 by upstream formula is x minus y, and means plus 44 kilometers downstream, that is 44 by downstream means x plus y, in 10 hours, that is 10, that is equal to next. Similarly, the next one, it in 13 hours it can go 40 kilometers, that is 40 by 40 kilometers upstream, upstream means x minus y, plus 55 kilometers downstream, 55 by x plus y is equals to, in how many hours? That is 13 hours. If you observe closely these two equations, denominators contains are x minus y and x plus y. Now, let us suppose let 1 by x minus y is equals to L, 1 by x plus y is equals to M. Now, the above equations reduces to 30L plus 44M is equal to 10. Similarly, 40L plus 55M is equal to 13. Let us consider this as equation 1, this is equation 2. Now, you have to solve equation 1 and 2 by any of the three methods. Any of the three methods means in your hand, elimination method, substitution method and cross multiplication method is there. Okay, let us go with the cross multiplication method. Now, identify the positions of A1, B1, C1 and A2, B2, C2. Now, let us see A1. First, write the B1 value, that is a 44. A1 is equals to 30. B1 is equal to 44. C1 is equal to, bring the constant inside, that is a minus 10. Next, A2 is equal to 40. B2 is equal to 55. C2 is equal to minus 13. Now, I am ready with the values of A1, B1, C1 and A2, B2, C2. Now, let us solve. Arrange these in order according to the formula part. That is 44 minus 10, 30, 44. Next, 55 minus 13, 40, 55. Now, x by 44 into minus 13 minus 55 into minus 10, that is equal to y by minus 10 into 40 minus 30 into minus 13 equal to 1 by 30 into 55 minus 40 into 44. Here my question is in terms of L and M. That's why I replace X and Y with L as well as M. Now next, L by minus 572 minus into minus plus 550 equal to M by, that is M by minus 400 plus 390 equal to 1 by 55 threes, 3 fives are 15, 165, that is 1650 minus 44 fours, 4 fours are 16, 176, that is 1760. Now L by minus 22 M by minus 10 is equal to 1 by, that is 1650 minus 1760. Do the calculation here, simplification, 1760, 1650, 0, 6 minus 1, 6 minus 5, 1, 7 minus 6, 1, that is 110, that is here 1760 is a more value, that is a minus value, therefore L is equal to minus 22 by minus 110, M is equal to minus 10 by minus 110. Now L is equal to 22 table, this cancels, 510, that is a 1 by 5. Now M is equal to 1 by 11. Now what is the L value here? 1 by x minus y. That is 1 by x minus y is equal to 1 by 5. Similarly, M is equal to 1 by x plus y is equal to 1 by 11. Now therefore what is the value? 1 numerators are equal, therefore x minus y is equal to 5 comma x plus y is equal to 11. Now here equation 1 and 2, let us consider this is equation 3, this is equation 4. Now solve equation 3 and equation 4, that is x minus y is equal to 5, x plus y is equal to 11, that is plus y minus y get cancelled, 2x is equal to 16, x is equal to 8. What is the x in the given question? That is the speed of the boat, x kilometers per hour. Therefore, speed of boat is equal to 8 km/h, 8 kilometers per hour. Okay, let us consider x value is 8. This is equation 5. Now, substitute 5 in equation 4, that is x plus y is equal to 11. What is x value? 8. 8 plus y is equal to 11. Y is equal to 11 minus 8. That is y is equal to 3. What is the y value in the given question? Speed of the stream. Therefore, speed of the stream is equal to 3 kilometers per hour. Okay, please follow the following models. The objective is reducing into the pair of linear equations. First of all, the given equations are irregular form. First of all, you convert it into the regular form. After that, you can able to solve. Now see, let 1 by x is equal to a, 1 by y is equal to b. Then the first one converts into, first equation converts into a by 2 plus 1 by y, nothing but b, that is b by 3 is equal to 2, comma 1 by 3x, that is 1 by x nothing but a, that is a by 3 plus 1 by y nothing but b, that is a b by 2 is equal to 13 by 6. Now please follow the LCM, convert into the regular form. That is LCM is a 6 here, 3a plus 2b is equal to 2, that is 3a plus 2b is equal to 2 6 are 12. Now come to the second one. Here also LCM is a 6, 3 table 6 cancels to 10, there is a 2a plus 3b is equal to 13 by 6, 6 6 get cancelled, 2a plus 3b is equal to 13. Now this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Now solve equation 1 and equation 2. Solve equation 1 and 2. Now to solve equation 1 and 2, either the coefficients of a or the coefficients of the b must be equal. Let us check whether they are equal or not. Coefficient of a is a 3, here the coefficient of a is a 2. No, not possible. Come to the coefficients of b. Coefficient of b is a 2 here and the coefficient of b here is a 3. But if that means in the both the cases the coefficients of a and b are unequal, then we have to make them equal. That is, I want to equate the coefficients of a. That is, first equation is multiplied by 2, second equation is multiplied by 3. Then 2 3s are 6a plus 4b is equal to 12, 2s are 24. 6a plus 9b is equal to 39. Now I made the coefficients of a are equal, but both have the same sign, then it is unable to eliminate. That's why change the signs, minus minus plus minus, then both cancels. 4b minus 9b, that is a minus 5b is equal to minus 9 minus 4, that is a 15, 39 minus 24, that is a 15, minus minus get cancelled, that is a b is equal to 5 table, 15 cancels 3 times, that is the value of the b is 3. Now this is equation 3. What is the b from the given question? B nothing but 1 by y, that is 1 by y is equal to 3, therefore y is equal to 1 by 3. Now I am ready with the value of y. Now come to the next step. Substitute equation 3 in equation 1, that is 3a plus 2b is equal to 12, that is 3a plus 2 times b value is a 3, that is 2 times 3 is equal to 12, that is 3a is equal to 12 minus 6 plus 6 goes other side minus 6, that is 3a is equal to 6, a is equal to 2, that is, what is the a from the given question, what is my supposition for a? 1 by x, that is 1 by x is equal to 2, therefore x is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, the values of x and y are ready with me. Therefore, the value of x is 1 by 2 and the value of y is 1 by 3. Let us see the next example. Here the denominators consisting the square roots, root x and the root y. Okay, let 1 by root x is equal to a, 1 by root y is equal to b. Then the above equations turns to 2a plus 3b is equal to 2 and 4a minus 9b is equal to minus 1. That is, now we can solve these two equations. This is equation 1, this is equation 2. Now, in equation 1 and 2, to solve this one, either the coefficients of A or the coefficients of B must be same. But here the coefficients of A and the coefficients of B must be different. To equate this, I multiply equation 1 by 3. Then solve 1 and 2. That is 3 into 2A, 6A plus 9B is equal to 6. Second equation, no changes, 4a minus 9b is equal to minus 1. That is, plus 9b minus 9b get cancelled. 10a is equal to 6 minus 1, 5. A is equal to 5 by 10. A is equal to 1 by 2. Highlight this a value. Yeah. What is meant by a? 1 by root x. That is, 1 by root x is equal to 1 by 2. Then squaring on both sides, that is squaring on both sides, what happens? 1 by x is equal to 1 by 4, therefore x is equal to 4. Now I am ready with the value of x. Now how to find the value of y? Now give, this is equation 3. Now follows, substitute equation 3 in equation 1, that is 2a plus 3b is equal to 2, 2 times a nothing but 1 by 2 plus 3b is equal to 2, 2 to get cancelled, 3b is equal to 2 plus 1 goes other side, the minus 1. 3b is equal to 1, b is equal to 1 by 3. What is nothing but b from the given question? 1 by root y. 1 by root y is equal to 1 by 3. Again, squaring on both sides, that is nothing but 1 by y is equal to 1 by 9, therefore y is equal to 9. Okay, therefore I am ready with the values of x and y. X is equal to 4 and y is equal to 9. Let us follow the next example. Reducing into pair of linear equations. Here the denominator is the compound one. Simple one means 1 by x, 1 by y, 1 by 2x, 1 by 3y, like that. But here the denominator contains a compound, that is a binomial. 3x plus y, 3x minus y. In the second equation also, 2 times of 3x plus y and 2 times of 3x minus y. Okay, now let us suppose 1 by 3x plus y equal to a and 1 by 3x minus y is equals to b. By substituting these values in the above equations reduces to a plus b is equal to 3 by 4 and a by 2 minus b by 2 is equal to minus 1 by 8. Now 4 will be cross multiplied, come on, 4a plus 4b is equal to 3, equation 1. Here the denominators are the same, therefore which can be changes to a minus b by 2 is equal to minus 1 by 8. Next step, this is as it is, this changes to a minus b is equal to 2 table which cancels 4 times, that is a minus 1 by 4. After cross multiplication, 4a minus 4b is equal to minus 1, this is equation 2. Now solve equation 1 and equation 2. Now 4a plus 4b is equal to 3, 4a minus 4b is equal to minus 1. Plus 4b minus 4b get cancelled. 4a plus 4a, that is 8a, is equal to 3 minus 1, that is equal to 2. That is a is equal to 2 by 8, which is nothing but a is equal to 1 by 4. A equal to 1 by 4. What is the mean by A in the given question? That is 1 by 3x plus y is equal to 1 by 4. Therefore, numerators are equal. Therefore, you can write 3x plus y is equal to 4. This is equation 3. Now, I am ready with the value of a, that is a 1 by 4. Substitute a is equal to 1 by 4. Substitute a is equal to 1 by 4 in equation 2. That is 4 times 1 by 4 minus 4b is equal to minus 1. 4, 4 get cancelled. 1 minus 4b is equal to minus 1. That is minus 4b is equal to minus 1 minus 1. Minus 4b is equal to minus 2. Minus minus get cancelled. B nothing but 2 by 4. That is, what is nothing but B in the given question? 1 by 3x minus y is equal to 2 by 4, nothing but 1 by 2. That is 3x minus y. 1 by 3x minus y is equal to 1 by 2. In either cases, numerators are same. Therefore, I conclude that 3x minus y is equal to 2, which is equation 4. Now, solve equation 3 and equation 4. Solve equation 3 and equation 4. That is, equation 3. 3x plus y is equal to 4. Next, 3x minus y is equal to 2. Plus y minus y get cancelled. That is 3x plus 3x. 6x is equal to 6. 6 get cancelled. That is equal to x is equal to 1. Which is equation 5. Substitute equation 5 in equation 4. That is 3x minus y is equal to 2, 3 times 1 minus y is equal to 2, minus y is equal to 2, plus 3 goes other side, minus 3, that is a minus y is equal to minus 1, minus minus get cancelled, y is equal to 1. Therefore, the values of x and y are, the values of x is equal to 1, the value of y is equal to 1. Let us follow the next example. Please observe the positions of the denominators here. Denominator is x minus 1 and the y minus 2. And in the second equation, the denominators are x minus 1 and y minus 2. That means denominators are the binomials. But in both the equations, the denominators are same. That is, let 1 by x minus 1 is equal to a, 1 by y minus 2 is equal to b. Let us suppose. Now, substitute these values in the above equations, which turns into 5a plus b is equal to 2. This is equation 1. Next, 6a minus 3b is equal to 1. This is equation 2. Now, to solve 1 and 2, either the coefficients of a or b must be equal. Okay, we are doing very often elimination method. Now, we solve this question by substitution method. Now, see, b is equal to 2 minus 5a. Let us, this is equation 3. Now, substitute equation 3 in equation 2. That is, 6a minus 3b is equal to 1. That is, 6a minus 3 times, what is the b value? 2 minus 5a is equals to 1. That is, 6a minus 3 2s are 6, minus into minus, plus 3 5s are 15a is equals to 1. That is, let us simplify, 6 plus 15, that is a 21a is equal to 1 plus, minus 6 goes other side, plus 6, that is 21a is equal to 7, that is a is equal to 7 by 21, that is a is equal to 1 by 3, a is equal to 1 by 3. Now see, a is equal to 1 by 3. Now, a nothing but 1 by x minus 1. Therefore, 1 by x minus 1 is equal to a nothing but 1 by 3. That is, in both the cases, in either sides, the numerators are same. Therefore, equate the denominators. X minus 1 is equal to 3. X is equal to 3 plus 1. X is equal to 4. Now, I am ready with the value of x. Now, similarly, you have to find out the value of the b next. Now, I am ready with the value of the x. Now, let us consider this as equation 4. That is, substitute equation 4 in equation 3. That is, b is equal to 2 minus 5a. That is, b is equal to 2 minus 5 into a nothing but 1 by 3. That is, b is equal to 2 minus 5 by 3. B is equal to 3 2s are 6 minus 5. That is a 1 by 3. B value is a 1 by 3. What is my supposition for b? 1 by y minus 2 is equal to 1 by 3. That is, in the either side the numerators are same, then equate the denominators. Y minus 2 is equal to 3. That is, y minus 2 is equal to 3, y is equal to 3 plus 2. Therefore, y is equal to 5. Okay, this is the question we solved by substitution method. Therefore, the value of x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 5. Let us check these values are right or wrong. Okay, please check. Please take the equation. 5 by x minus 1 plus 1 by y minus 2 is equal to 2. That is 5 by, what is x value? 4. 4 minus 1 plus 1 by, what is the y value? 5. 5 minus 2 is equal to 2. That is equal to 5 by 3 plus 1 by 3 is equal to 2. That is, the denominators are same. That is, a 5 plus 1, 6 by 3 is equal to 2. 2 is equal to 2. That is, hence verified. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. Therefore, it is hence verified. Okay, our next problem is solving the graphs. Solve graphically, share the region bounded by the lines and y-axis. Here two equations are given. Before going to solve graphically, first of all you have to be able to find out the coordinates. Place that coordinate on the graph sheet and verify where the two lines intersect each other on the y-axis. Now, before going to solve this question, let us check whether these are what type of lines. That is, very beginning itself we discuss about what is the nature of the lines, intersecting lines, parallel lines or coincident lines. Okay, let us check the condition. A1 by A2, that is 4 by 3. A1 by A2 is a 4 by 3. B1 by B2 is a minus 1 by 2. Okay. Therefore, I concluded that A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. Therefore, I can conclude that these two lines are intersect each other. Okay. Now, first of all, from these linear equations, you convert y as a subject. Now, see, 4x plus 4 bring this side, minus 4, minus 4 is equal to y. That is, y is equal to 4x minus 4. Next, from this one, convert y as a subject. 2y is equal to 14 minus 3x and y is equal to 14 minus 3x by 2. Now, I want to find out the coordinates. That is, I need minimum three coordinates. Maximum you can x, y. If I put x value is a 0, if I place x value is a 0, what is the y value? Minus 4. Next, I want to place y value is 2. If I want to place x value is a 2, that is 4 2s are 8 minus 4, 4. Next, if I want to place minus 1, I want to place. Minus 1 I want to place means minus 4, minus 4, minus 8. That means you can move up to minus 8. That is why I change the negative value. Next, I want to place value is a 1. That is 4 ones are 4 minus 4, that is a 0. Now, xy. Again, first I want to place x value is a 0. If I place x value is 0, 14 by 2, that is a 7. Now, I want to place 4. Then, what is happened? See, x value 4, 3 4s are 12. 14 minus 12, 12. Sorry, 14 minus 12, 2. 2 by 2, nothing but 1. Next, I want to place 3. I want to place minus 3. Minus 3. Now, let us check. Let us check what is the value we will get in the rough. That is 14 minus 3 times minus 3 by 2. That is 14 plus 9 by 2. 14 plus 9, 23 is an odd number. Odd number means, okay, you can take, but the value is not round. Round value you can take. That is, I will take minus 2 next. Then, minus 2 means what number? That is 14 plus 6, 20. 20 by 2, 10. That is, now let us see the coordinates of the first equation are 0 comma minus 4, 2 comma 4, 1 comma 0, and coordinates of second one 0 comma 7, 4 comma 1, minus 2 comma 10. Now let us see, now let us draw the graph. X positive, x negative, y positive, y negative. The point of intersection of x and y axis is called as origin. Now, in the x coordinates, what's the highest value? 0, 2, 1, 0, 4, minus 2. That is, let us take the distance 1, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Similarly, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Now, on the y-axis highest value, minus 4, 4, 0, 7, 1, 10. That is, on the y-axis the highest value is a 10. And the least value is a minus 4. That's why I will convert distance is a 2. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Okay, on the y-axis the distance is 2 units. On the x-axis the distance is 1 unit. That is next, minus 2, minus 4, minus 6, minus 8. Okay, enough. After that, now you can place the points. 0, comma, minus 4. 0, comma, minus 4. Clearly, it is a point on negative y-axis. Why? Because the x value is a 0. Now you can say, on y-axis, where the minus 4? On y-axis, minus 4. Round this. 2 comma 4. 2 comma 4 means on x. On x-axis, 2. On y-axis, 4. 2 comma 4. Next. 1 comma 0, 1 comma 0 is a clearly is a point on x-axis. Why? Because y value is 0. That is 1 comma 0. This is a point. Now, from the equation, from the first quadrant, from the first linear equation, the three points are placed on the graph paper. Now, you can join these three points by straight line. Then what is the name of this equation right here? 4x minus y equal to 4. Next, come to the second one. 0, 7 is a point on x-axis, but on the x-axis 0, 7 is a point on y-axis. Why? Because x value is a 0. On y-axis 7, 7 means which lies in between 6 and 8. Because it is maintaining to 2 units distance. Now 4, 1 means on x-axis 4, y-axis 1. Y-axis 1 means this is the 1. That is, here you have to. Third one is -2, 10. -2 on x-axis -2, y-axis is 10. Y-axis is 10. On y-axis 10. This is the point. Now, you can join these three points by a straight line. Just make adjust this one. Down. Then, what is the name of the graph? The name of the graph is 3x plus 2y is equal to 14. Now, where these two graphs intersect each other? The two lines intersect each other at x value 2 and y value 4. Now, the two lines, that is the lines 4x minus y is equal to 4 and 3x plus 2y is equal to 1 by 4, intersect at the point 2, 4. Okay, therefore the two lines intersect at the point 2, 4. What is mean for that? This 2, 4 is a solution of both the equations. Let us check 2, 4. That means x value is a 2, y value is a 4. That means substitute in the above equation. 4 2s are 8. Let us check here. First one, 4x minus y is equal to 4. Our point is 2, 4. Let us check this one. That means 4 times 2 minus 4 is equal to 4. 8 minus 4 is equal to 4. 4 is equal to 4. Yes, satisfied. True. Well, come to the second one. 3x plus 2y is equal to 14. 2, 4. That is 3 times 2 plus 2 times 4 is equal to 14. 6 plus 8 is equal to 14. 14 is equal to 14. Hence verified. That is, 2, 4 is a common point for the both linear equations. Okay. Now, rest of the part. Share the region bounded by the lines and y-axis. Come on. Where these two lines touches the y-axis? This one, that is name A of. What is this point name? This is a point on y-axis, that is 0, 7. Second one here, this is, name it, this is a B of 2, 4. Second one, C of, it is a point on y-axis, that is 0, -4. This part, now we have to share, that is this part. Now, therefore, the coordinates of, therefore, here you can write, coordinates of triangle ABC are A of 0, 7, B of 2, 4, C of 0, -4. After the last part, you have to write at the top, scale x-axis 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit. Y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 2 units. Let us see the next example. Solve graphically, share the region bounded by the lines and the x-axis. Here two equations are given. First of all, convert these two equations as y as the subject to find the coordinates. After that, place the coordinates on the graph paper. By joining them, these two intersect at one point. After that, where these points locates on the x-axis, including with the intersecting point, then you have to take the points, then you can get the answer of x-axis. Now, let us make subject answer. 3x minus 3 is equal to y. Plus 3 brings inside, there is a minus 3. Therefore, y is equal to 3x minus 3. Next, convert y as a subject, that is x plus 4 is equal to 2y. Therefore, y is equal to x plus 4 by 2. In the both the cases, y converted as a subject. Now you have to find out the coordinates. X, y. If I place x value 0, what is the y value? That is a minus 3. Now, if I want to place x value as 1, 3 ones are 3, 3 minus 3, that is a 0. Next, if I want to place the y value as minus 1, minus 2, minus 1 I want to place. Minus 1 if I want to place, what is the answer? Minus 3, that is a minus 6. Next, come to this one. If I want to place the x value is a 0, 4 by 2, nothing but 2. Next, if I want to place our x value as a minus 4, minus 4 plus 4 get cancelled, 0 by any number, that is a 0. Next, if I want to place the x value as a 2, 2 plus 4, that is a 6, 6 by 2, nothing but 3. Therefore, coordinates are, for this equation, 0 comma minus 3, 1 comma 0, minus 1 comma 6. For this one, 0 comma 2, minus 4 comma 0, and 2 comma 3. First of all, identify the positions of x coordinates, 0, 1, minus 1, 0, minus 4, 2. There is a maximum value is 2 and the minimum value is a minus 4. Similarly, identify the positions of y coordinate. Minus 3, 0, 6, 2, 0, 3. There the highest value is a 6 and the least value is 0. Sorry, minus 0, yes. Now, plot the graph. Point of intersection of x and y axis is called origin. X positive, x negative, y positive and y negative. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. on x-axis the least value is up to minus 4 is there. That is, we can extend this one. That is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Now on y-axis, take one distance 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. Now please locate the points. 0, minus 3. 0, minus 3 is a point on negative y-axis. That is 0, minus 3. 1, 0 is a point on x-axis. Minus 1, 6. Minus 1. Minus 1, 6. Minus 1, minus 6. Sorry, this is minus 1, minus 6. That is minus 1. That is a minus 6. That is minus 6. That is up to here. Minus 1, minus 6. Now join these three points. What is the name of the graph? 3x minus 3 equal to y. Come to the second one. 0, 2 is a point on y-axis. On y-axis 2. Minus 4, 0 is a point on negative x-axis. 2, 3, this is a 2, this is a 3, 2, 3, now join these three points, the name of the graph is x minus 2y is equal to minus 4. The point of intersection of these two is 2 comma 3. That is 2 comma 3 will satisfy these two equations. Now share the region bounded by the lines x-axis. Come on, x-axis a of minus 4 comma 0, b of 2 comma 3, c of 1 comma 0. Now highlight this. Therefore what you can conclude, that points therefore coordinates of triangle ABC are R a of minus 4 comma 0, b of 2 comma 3, and c of 1 comma 0, and the two lines intersected the point 2 comma 3. This 2 comma 3 is the common solution for the both the lines. Okay, now let us check. First equation is 3x minus 3. 3x minus y is equal to 3. Common point is 2 comma 3. Let us substitute. 3 times 2 minus 3 is equal to 3. 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. 3 is equal to 3. Hence verified. Next, come to the second one. X minus 2y is equal to minus 4. That is, what is the x? 2 comma 3, 2 minus 2 times y nothing but 3 is equal to minus 4, 2 minus 6 is equal to minus 4, minus 4 is equal to minus 4. Hence verified. Let us see the next example. Solve graphically and shade the region bounded by the lines and x-axis. The given linear equations are 5x minus 6y plus 30 is equal to 0 and 5x plus 4y minus 20 is equal to 0. Now, first of all, from these two linear equations, convert y as a subject to make you find the coordinate simple. That is, from this one, 6y is equal to 5x plus 30, that is minus 6y moves to the other side, that will become a plus 6y. Now, y is equal to 5x plus 30 by 6. Now, subject is over. Next, from this one, 4y is equal to 20 minus 5x, that is minus 20 take other side, the plus 20 plus 5x moves other side minus 5x. Therefore, y is equal to 20 minus 5x by 4. That means from the both the linear equations, y converted as a subject. Now find the coordinates. X, y. If you place x value is 0, what is the y value? 30 by 6, that is a 5. Next, if you take minus 2 value here, minus 2, that is 5 times minus 2, minus 10 plus 30, 20 by 6 fraction is coming. That's why don't prefer such values. Now, if you take next in place of x, minus 6 take, that is minus 5 into minus 6, minus 30 plus 30, minus 30 plus 30 get cancelled. That is 0 by any number, that is a 0. Next, what is the third value? You can prefer any number, but don't prefer the fractions. Cut. Next, take the value 3 in place of x. That is 5 times 3, 15. 15 plus 30, 45. 45 by 6. 45 by 6, that is it will come 7.5. therefore, the coordinates are 0 comma 5, minus 6 comma 0, 3 comma 7.5. next, welcome to the second linear equation to find the coordinates. Let us see x, y. If I place x value is a 0, 20 by 4, 5. After that, in place of x, I want to place 4. 5 4s are 20. That is 20 minus 20, 0. 0 by any number, 0. Actually, these two values are sufficient for us. Therefore, the coordinates are 0, 5 and 4, 0. Now we want to place the coordinates on the graph sheet. Now let us follow. First of all, identifies what is the highest value on x axis. 0, minus 6, 3, 0, 4. x dash, y dash, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. That is on x-axis, minus 6 is there. That is, extend this line. Minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. Now, on y-axis, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. Now, locate the points. 0, 5 is a point on y-axis. Next, minus 6, 0 is a point on x-axis. Next, 7.5 is at the top. 0, 5 is a point on y-axis, okay. Next, minus 6, 0 is a point on, minus 6, 0 is a point on the x-axis. Now, join these two. Now, the name of the graph is 5x minus 6y plus 30 equal to 0. Welcome to the second one. 0, 5, again the point on y-axis. 4, 0 is a point on, now join these two. The name of the graph is 5x plus 4y minus 20 is equal to 0. Now, what are the coordinates I received? A of 0, 5. B of, it is a point on x-axis, minus 6, 0. C of 4, 0. Therefore, the given lines, both the lines intersect at the point A of 0, 5, which is the common point for the both the linear equations, and you have to share the x-axis. Now, this is x-axis only, on this x-axis only, these two lines intersect. Now, share this region. Now, therefore, write coordinates of triangle are coordinates of triangle A, B, C are A of 0, 5, B of minus 6, 0 and C of 4, 0. Now, common point for these two lines are A of 0, 5. That means 0, 5 satisfies the both the equations. Let us check algebraically. Now, this is the graphically. Now, we can check algebraically. Check, what's the first equation? 5x minus 6y plus 30 is equal to 0, which passes through the point 0, 5. That is 5 times 0. Minus 6 times 5 plus 30 is equal to 0. 0 minus 30 plus 30 is equal to 0. 0 is equal to 0. hence verified. Now please collect the second equation. Second equation is 5x plus 4y, 5x plus 4y minus 20 is equal to 0. That means in this equation substitute the point 0 comma 5, whether it satisfies or not. 5 times 0 plus 4 times 5 minus 20 is equals to 0. 0 plus 20 minus 20 is equal to 0, that is a 0 is equals to 0. Therefore, what we conclude, that is a of 0 comma 5 is the common solution for both the linear equations, and the region of the x-axis, the coordinates of x-axis and the triangle are a of 0 comma 5, b of minus 6 comma 0, c of 4 comma 0. See the next question. Solve graphically shade the region bounded by the lines and x-axis. Find the area of the shaded region. That means from the shaded region you can find the area of the region. That is, the given equations are 2x plus y is equal to 6, 2x minus y is equal to minus 2. That means from the both the linear equation, first convert y as a subject. That is, y is equal to minus 2x plus 6 from the first equation. From the second equation, y is equal to minus y, take other side, that is a plus y. Now 2x minus 2 bring inside, that is a plus 2. That is, from the both the sides convert y as a subject. Okay, now find the coordinates. That is, just I am considering only two coordinates, that is x, y. If I want to place x value as a 0, x value as a 0, y value is a 6. And if I place x value is a 3, there is a minus 2 times 3, there is a minus 6 plus 6 get cancelled, which will give you 0. Next, in the second one, xy, if you place x value as 0, 2 times 0, 0 plus 2, that is a 2. Next, if you place in place of x minus 1, 2 times minus 1, minus 2 plus 2, that is also becomes 0. Therefore, coordinates are 0 comma 6 and 3 comma 0. And here the coordinates are 0 comma 2 and minus 1 comma 0. That is, draw the graph. Now, x, x dash, y, y dash, 0. On x axis, the highest value is 3. That is, take the distance of 1 unit, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. On y axis, the highest value is 6. Now, let us consider the unit distance 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, negative y axis, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Now, plot the points. 0 comma 6 is a point on y axis since x value is 0. That is, next, 3 comma 0, point on, 3 comma 0 is a point on x axis. Now, join these two. The name of the graph is 2x plus y is equal to 6. Welcome to the second part. 0 comma 2 is a point on y axis. Since x value is 0, that is on y axis 2. 0 comma 2. Minus 1 comma 0. Minus 1 comma 0 is a point on. Minus 1 comma 0 is a point on x axis. Now join these two. Move along. That is, the name of the graph is 2x minus y is equal to minus 2. That is, both the points intersect at, that is, it is a 1, x value 1, y value is a 4. That is, at 1, 4 is a common solution for both the linear equations. Therefore, 1, 4 is a common solution for both the linear equations. Now, after that, from the question, what we want? That is, region bounded by the lines. Yes, region bounded by the lines is this one. And x-axis. That means, you have to share the x-axis. Yes. Therefore, the coordinates are, this is A of, now B of, this is the x-axis, minus 1 comma 0, C of 3 comma 0. Therefore, here you can write, therefore, vertices of triangle ABC are A of 1 comma 4, B of minus 1 comma 0, C of 3 comma 0. Now, from the question, again it is asked that find the area of the shaded region. That means we have to find out the area of this one. Okay, before going to do this one, the two lines intersected at the point 1 comma 4. That is, let us check whether it is right or wrong. First one is 2x plus y is equal to 6, passing through the point 1 comma 4. That is, 2 times 1 plus 4 is equal to 6. That is, 2 plus 4 is equal to 6, 6 is equal to 6. Yes, it is hence verified. LHS and RHS both are equal. Therefore, 1 comma 4 is the solution of the given lines. Now, second one, similarly, you have to find the second one. Second equation is 2x minus y is equal to minus 2. That is, 2 times passing through the point 1 comma 4. 2 times 1 minus 4 is equal to minus 2. 2 minus 4 is equal to minus 2. Minus 2 is equal to minus 2. Therefore, the point which satisfies the second equation is also. Therefore, 1 comma 4 is also the solution of second linear equation. The next part I have to find out the area of the shaded region. That is, area of triangle ABC I have to find. Area of triangle ABC is equal to formula, half into base into height. That is, half into, there is a base, from here to here it is a base. That is, BC is your base. How many units it is occupied? That is, 1, 2, 3, 4. Your base occupied 4 units. Into height. That means from here to here, how much height is there? 0 to 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is, height is 4 units. Therefore, the area I conclude that is 2 fours are 8 square units is the area of the region of triangle ABC. Therefore, area of triangle ABC is 8 square units.